Trevor, good to see you. How are you, sir? You well?
So are we playing that game where we bopped it?
We're live to the UK audience right at this moment.
Oh, I gotta be serious there.
We had an interesting start there. We had Khabib obviously weighed in first on the scales. Looked very relieved on the scales. I don't know whether you were here for that, but you could see the relief was all over his face that he'd made weight strip right down. And then Michael Chandler, obviously the reserve, weighed in, and we were kind of saying, "Where's Justin? Where's Justin?" But he comes in, cruises in, cool as a cucumber. It was never going to be an issue, was there?
Never. That's one thing that we focus on, is not making the cuts hard. So we really just take our time and enjoy the process. So it's we had issues. I wouldn't say issues, but weight cuts were a lot tougher in the World Series when he was doing it. And once he made the cuts easier, he realized, hey, this is way better for me. I perform better, and I save it for the octagon. So again, I think cutting weight is the most dangerous part of the sport. And I try to advise my athletes. I don't tell them. I advise them to, you know, be smart with your weight.
Yeah, absolutely.
Spare me 1 second, Trevor. We're just waiting for Ankalaev to hit the scales. Once we have his confirmation, got loads of questions about, obviously, preparation for this monster fight at the weekend for you. But here he is, Magomed Ankalaev. This is a fight, of course, that we've been speaking about for quite some time against Jan Kutalaba. It's been on, off. They've obviously had that fight before where Kutalaba tried to fox the referee. He ended up foxing him a little bit too much, but he's done. There you go. Ankalaev taking on Jan Kutalaba. Get excited about that. Talk to me about the psychology of the men event, because getting to sit down with Justin this week and talking to him, he's an incredibly guy, very switched on guy. Mm-hmm. When God was making him, I think he forgot to take quit out of the actual makeup of this kid. He's a kid that's going to go all the way.
Yeah, it's his mental toughness, I did not have to teach. You know, I work on that with all my athletes. It's one of my favorite parts. And, I mean, he's a natural man when it comes to the mental state.
One thing we constantly talk about with Justin is we reference this All-American wrestling. We're wrestling. It's always about the wrestling's there if he needs it. It's there if he needs it. But he's never needed it. You know, he's knuckled the highlight for no other reason except every fight he's in, including World Series of Fighting. And he's brought into the UFC bonuses for every single performance he's been in. He is a true fan's favorite. But could this be the fight, Trevor, when we finally do see that All-American defensive wrestling?
I mean, it could be. I mean, I'd probably say so with Khabib's wrestling. But, I mean, you never know. Justin's footwork's really good. Again, I expect Khabib to take us down. A lot of people are like, hey, can he take him down? I say, I expect him to. You know, we don't fear that. And I believe our scrambles will create opportunities, and it's going to be different. You know, it's sometimes you want people to feel what you have on that other side and kind of, and then smile back in their face. That's that's how you win the mental battle.
Of course. Well, we were giggling last night, and I said to Adam, imagine if the bell goes for the first round and Justin sprints across the octagon, picks Khabib up and puts him on his back. What would that do to the world? I think we'd all lose it.
Well,
can we do that?
I would say I'll put my house on. We're not going to do that. You know, I'm not out here to push our game plans, but Justin's going to be Justin, you know?
Yeah.
On a big occasion like this, how much is it meant to him being able to have his parents alongside him for this ride? You know, we're not allowed fans in these types of arenas, but to have his mum and dad with him, who've been there since day one, must be a big thing.
It was really special. That was hard for me on the last one. And if it's hard for me, I know it's hard for him. I could really read his energy, and that was tough. But he also took that fight because what was going on. Mm-hmm. And he wanted to inspire people. And that was tough, though. You know, he's out there trying to put people in a positive mindset, including family and friends, and it was tough. So this has been a lot better already, just from the environment and having his parents around. So I'm excited, really excited to have the crew back. And I mean, thank Dana for allowing that. Justin had asked him, called him up, and asked him, and there was nothing said by Dana, but hey, give me their passports.
The performance against Tony Ferguson was the very best Justin Gaethje we've seen. Now, you're with him day by day, Trevor, in the gym. How much more is there to go? Is there another 5%, 10%, 20% in there that we've not even seen yet?
Yeah, I think, you know, it's the top of the level. And when you're at the top of the level, some fights look like that. And styles make fights. And I'm never going to falter to, oh, my gosh, he's that good. He's that good. But I'm not going to falter and make comments that we just outclass him and he's going to continue to get better. you face different opponents, you have different obstacles in front of you. This is a complete different obstacle. The next fight's going to be a different obstacle, and it's really how we perform and how do we adapt in there. We know Khabib, but what Khabib's going to come out when he's switched and striked, and people are worried about his wrestling and he'll outstrike guys.
Right,
so
hand.
It's again, I don't really want to look at that fight. A lot of people are like, man, he looks the best. He can beat anybody like that. And I'm like, yeah, I've always wanted that Tony fight, you know. Mm-hmm. Looking from the outside, I feel, you know, it was a great style. And not to take credit away from Justin, he did what you need to do against Tony. And he looked spectacular.
Yeah.
And the main thing is he was having fun. When you're having fun, your performances look better.
Yeah.
That's the key to this. If you go out there and you fight, you're going to be tense. You're going to be locked up. And once you lock up, your energy levels go down. You know, hold the flex for 1 minute, and then you'll be like, whoa, and you're not even doing anything. The thing is, get out there, get in flow, have fun, and know that millions of people are watching you. And when you tell stuff like that to Gaethje, he just, he really has fun, and then he puts on great performances.
Just a final one from us. Just with there not being a big crowd, because this would comfortably sell out arenas wherever we are in the world, does it make your job slightly easier without that adrenaline of the crowd for him to react to? Because when he does come back to the corner, he's 100% lasered into your words and following out your instructions.
No, I wouldn't even look at it that way, because again, I don't want the perfect environment for us. I want new experiences, mm-hmm. and I want challenging experiences, and sometimes it's easier, sometimes it's not. I don't really look at that. Again, if it was easier to have it this way, I wouldn't say, hey, can we do it that way? I wouldn't be the one. It's like, for me, I think what makes fighting so great is you show up in different countries, different time zones. We're fighting at a different time than last time when I was out in Abu Dhabi. These experiences are different, and that's what makes fighters so unique. You can't adapt. And every time you fight someone, you're not facing the same team you faced last year.
Of course.
Like other sports. This is, you're facing someone new every time.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, to me, super unique. And I love that part of this game. Again, I said it yesterday, it's not about winning or losing to me. It really isn't. I'm a coach, and I coach to perform. And if you're performing, you get the wins.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I want to coach people for life and for experiences. And one thing about fighting is I've seen it change people's lives. And for me to see people adapt to chaos, they're going to be great in life.
Yeah, I'm sure they will. And he loves the chaos. There's Mr. Gaethje, and we're looking forward to tomorrow. Yeah. Listen, enjoy the last 36 hours before it all gets underway tomorrow.
I appreciate it.
Trevor, thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
You're free to go. You
all
can
right,
have the you can have the rest of your day.
I've never played that game. I always love it. We'll see you guys.
Take care.
Trevor Wittman there, head coach of Justin Gaethje. Great spirits. He's in a great mood, and obviously his man hitting 155.
Yep.
We're good to go for
a minute. We were panicking, but he wasn't. He was fine about it.